Everyone, and welcome back to another video on Maanav Sports Talk. Let's go right into my power rankings for week 10, 1 through 16 as usual. Let's get into the power rankings. For the power rankings, as you can see, there are quite a bit of changes here. This week was many different teams were performing at different levels, so I had to really shake up the power rankings here. Now we have the Chiefs moving back into that one spot. Super Bowl champs, that offense is just too great. Defensively, again, they still need to improve a little bit because you have these teams, the Panthers, you know, showing up. But they're still able to get the wins, you know, and it may be close in the beginning, but the Chiefs are able to finish it off. And then got the Steelers here. I know they're undefeated, but the thing was, against Dallas, like, it wasn't supposed to be this close. You can't make it that close. You can't let those kind of bad teams come so close and almost win it. You can't let them steal those games from you. You have to be able to put your foot on the pedal in those games and dominate. And the Steelers are just not able to do that. I'm surprised that their defense gave up what they did against the fourth string quarterback of the Cowboys. But yeah, either way, I think the Chiefs are going to beat the Steelers when it comes to the important times. Now the big jump, it's the Saints. The Saints are my biggest jump. They were like number 8 last week or something. And now they jump all the way up to the top 3. Mostly because of their, you know, super dominating, heroic win over the Saints. Like a complete destruction of the Tampa Bay Buccaneers took place on Sunday Night Football. Where it was 31-0 at one point. So it was pretty bad. The Saints smoked the Buccaneers terribly. Drew Brees is looking great now. Now that you have Michael Thomas back healthy. And Kamara obviously is their MVP. And Drew Brees has gotten said with the other guys like Manuel Sanders. So the Saints are looking really good. And defensively, Malcolm Jenkins is really becoming a natural in their defense now. And yeah, their defense is much better than years before. And they're able to get pressure and have a solid secondary as well. So the Saints, you know, pretty balanced. And their offense is becoming stronger each week. Now here are the Ravens. Pretty much in the same spot. They just jump up one because of the Buccaneers. They had a good win against the Colts. The Colts are a pretty good team. They beat them. And then their Lamar Jackson is slowly, you know, he's not having as good of a year as he had last year. But he's still getting it done. He's learning new ways to win, and his defense is very good. Number 5, the Packers. Another dominating win over a weak team. Well, their offense is looking insane. Aaron Rodgers, Aaron Jones, and Devontae Adams, the best trio you can get right now. And they're looking really good. It's just that defensively, they have to improve if they really want to beat, you know, some of these other teams. Because every now and then, you're not expecting this offense to show up every single time. It's too much to expect from the Packers because sometimes they may not show up. The defense also has to be good enough. 6, the Buffalo Bills, they made a statement. They were able to get a huge win over the Seattle Seahawks the other night, scoring 44 points. Josh Allen is looking incredible right now. He has developed tremendously from last year. He is playing very well, you know. He's passing like 400 yards. He's able to use his rushing ability. The Bills offensively are looking pretty strong. They were able to beat such a good team in Seattle. And he was able to outduel Russell Wilson. And his defense is also pretty good. The Bills defense is pretty good. But, you know, I think they can be really good when they play well. They're one of the top defenses to me. And if the defense plays well, then you're looking at Josh Allen. These Bills can actually be a real force. Number 7, the Seahawks, right below the Bills. Russell Wilson did not have too good of a game, although he did put up 34 points or something. But he threw 2 interceptions, and their defense just sucks, honestly. If they want to actually win it, their defense has to play better. Number 8, the Tennessee Titans. Solid win down in Chicago. And not Chicago, in Tennessee, they're able to beat Chicago. AJ Brown, he is looking great. He has an explosive ability like DK Metcalf. And Ryan Tannehill is looking pretty good as well. And then Derrick Henry is always there. King Henry. Defensively, they need to be a little bit better, but they're a pretty solid team in my opinion. Number 9, the Buccaneers, a huge drop. It was pretty ugly, embarrassing, and just disgusting, honestly, for the Buccaneers. It was the worst loss of Tom Brady's historic career. In his entire career, college or professional, worst ever, 38-3 loss, where the offense looked lethargic and just bad. They weren't able to generate anything. Defensively, they did not look good at all. They completely broke down. And the Buccaneers really need to rethink who they are and what their strengths are. Number 10, the Cardinals. I think they're a pretty good team. Offensively, very good. Kyler Murray is playing like an MVP, honestly. Their offense is really good, in my opinion. Defensively, they still need to improve a little bit. Have some good players like Buda Baker, like I've been saying. You know, they're a young team, and I think they can go a long ways this season. 10, the Raiders, and then 12, Rams, 13, Colts, and the 14 are the Dolphins. So the Raiders, they're able to squeak by the LA Chargers. They're able to squeak by them. They're able to hold on the last play. You know, they're pretty good. They have a solid way of winning using their running back, Josh Jacobs. And defensively, obviously, they're not a very good defense, but offensively, Derek Carr has to be a game manager. You have some weapons there. And the Raiders, you know, have a knack of pulling out wins this year. The Rams, they're not too good. I mean, they're okay. They're not like that explosive offense, but defensively, they're much better. They have a really good secondary. And then obviously, Aaron Donald is very good. So the Rams, they're there, but I just don't think they're at that level yet. The Colts, the best defense in the league by stats, and they're a pretty good defense. Offensively, Phillip Rivers has to be more consistent if they really want to take the division and jump higher. 14 is the Dolphins. They are some story this year. They are playing, you know, great. They're playing freely. They have some sort of, you know, ability. They're able to, like, play loose. They're able to have fun, it seems like. It's kind of like a magic run for these Dolphins. With Tua Tagovailoa coming in, having a great game in Arizona. He was looking great. He was able to use his athletic ability as well. And defensively, they have some ability to generate turnovers and make big plays. And the Dolphins, you know, they may actually sneak into the playoffs somehow. 15, the Browns, had a bye week. And then 16 are the Vikings. They jump in here. Dalvin Cook has been an MVP-style player. Over 200 yards once again. And they just rely on him offensively. It'll be good. And defensively, they really need to get their secondary to be better. But, you know, they played well against the Bears, although the Bears' offense is trash. But the Vikings are going on a roll now. So those are my power rankings. Now let's go into my predictions for Week 10. We got a couple of good games this week. Actually, you know, 6 good games. You know, spread throughout the day on Sunday and on Thursday Night Football as well as Monday night. So this week, you know, we're looking forward to some really good games. After last week, got some really entertaining ones like the Chiefs, Panthers, Cardinals, Dolphins. You know, those games are really good. And this week, we're looking at some of the similar matchups that could be really, really great. Let's start off with the Texans and Browns. I know you may not think much of this matchup, but I think it's going to be a sneaky good game of the week. Deshaun Watson, any game of Deshaun Watson will be a good game. You have to understand that, first of all. And then you're facing the Browns. The Texans will be facing the Browns, okay? The Browns have a really good running game. So that's the Texans' weakness, is stopping the run. So you're looking at the Browns, you know, possibly running all over the Texans with Kareem Hunt and possibly Nick Chubb if he gets activated from injured reserve. And Baker Mayfield, if the Browns are going to win, Baker Mayfield has to be turnover free. I think he might have a couple of turnovers here in this game, and the Texans might take advantage. It's going to be a pretty close game throughout. Myles Garrett is going to be an important key because he can get to Deshaun Watson, and Deshaun has a tendency to hold on to the ball, and he'll be able to sack him quite a bit. That's probably what's going to be happening in this game. But let's get into my prediction. I think it's going to be really close. I'm Zach. Browns and Texans, I think a sneaky good game over here. You know, Deshaun Watson will make any game interesting in the Browns with their running game. Can they get to Deshaun Watson? Browns 34, Texans coming up short, going down once more. Now we're going to be jumping right into this Thursday Night Football matchup tomorrow. The Colts, Indianapolis Colts, taking on the Tennessee Titans in an all-important AFC South matchup rivalry. It's going to be very important. I think this will be a great game on Thursday Night Football. Definitely looking forward to it. The Indianapolis Colts, surprisingly, they're the number one ranked defense. I don't know how, but they are. Again, it has to do with probably Darius Leonard, Xavier Rhodes. What am I saying? Xavier Rhodes, and then they have DeForest Buckner, who they acquired. Pretty good defense. So Ryan Tannehill is going to have to take care of the ball. Derrick Henry didn't have too good of a game last week. Needs to show up. You know, maybe go into the end zone, have some big runs to wear down that Colts defense. And A.J. Brown. I don't think anybody can really guard A.J. Brown. The guy's huge. He's powerful. He's strong. You know, there's nobody who can really guard him. Similarly to D.K. Metcalf. So, it's going to be interesting to see. Ryan Tannehill definitely needs to target A.J. Brown. Jonnu Smith is another weapon. And Corey Davis as well. So, the Titans have generally a pretty good offense, in my opinion. The question is, can they even score enough? But for the Colts side, it's Phillip Rivers. He's been very inconsistent this year, and I'm not sure whether he can put up a really good performance. He generally has a knack of turning the ball over. I think the Titans might get a couple of chances there, maybe forcing a takeaway from Phillip Rivers. But it's going to be a very close game, a little bit low scoring. Thursday Night Football matchup should be great. Got the Titans taking on the Colts, you know, finally for a good Thursday night game. AFC South, who's going to take the lead here? I've got an idea. The Colts, only 17. The Titans, 23. We ran into the Panthers versus Buccaneers game. This will also be at 12 o'clock. By the way, the Texans and Browns game is at 12 o'clock. It'll be on Fox, okay? And then the Buccaneers-Panthers will be at 12 o'clock on Fox as well. The Buccaneers, you know, terrible loss. Already talked about in the power rankings. I think they'll rebound strongly here. The Panthers, they played great. They played with so much energy, you know, passion against the Chiefs, ultimately coming short because the Chiefs are the best team in the league. So, but I think the Buccaneers will bounce back. The Panthers, they're a tough team, well-coached team. They'll definitely put up a fight, but I think the Buccaneers get the job done after a terrible performance last week. Bucks, NFC North matchup. I think this might actually be a pretty good game. Let's take a look. Panthers 26, Buccaneers. This time, after that horrendous, embarrassing loss, come back and get a nice win here over their rival Panthers. So, Cardinals and Buffalo Bills. 3:05. It'll be at 3:05. You know, it's going to be 3:05 on CBS. I think Jim Nantz and Tony should be calling this game. It's going to be great seeing Kyler Murray and Josh Allen go head-to-head. Kyler Murray, I think, should be in the MVP race. He's been amazing, both rushing the ball and throwing it this year. And Josh Allen, you know, he really played well against the Seahawks after a couple of, you know, fiery performances. He definitely lit it up against the Seahawks. And this should be a very high-scoring game. It should be really entertaining. Both quarterbacks just make tons of plays happen with their legs. Should be so fun to watch. But you're looking at the Bills, who are probably the more complete team, in my opinion. Their defense is slightly better. But both teams have so many weapons offensively. It's going to be a shootout. And Kyler Murray is definitely going to lead this team well. But I think Josh Allen, you know, is really taking his Bills team to the next level this year. And their defense is better. I feel like they may force a turnover here. They forced two against Russell Wilson. They may force some here against Murray. And I think the Bills will escape with a victory after a very high-scoring, hard-fought game. Cardinals and Bills, this could be the game of the week. Look for a really high-scoring game. Both powerful offenses led by Kyler Murray and Josh Allen. I think if you really want to see a great game, definitely watch it. Look at my score prediction. Cardinals 35, Bills 41. They've scored 40 again. Another NFC West rivalry, the Seahawks taking on the Rams at 3:25 on Fox. Should be a great game. The Seahawks, their defense is pretty bad, honestly, pretty trash, honestly. But Russell Wilson is leading the charge for them. And I think he may be able to do good, but not, you know, that cooking style, which he did last time. He made a couple of mistakes in his cooking last week, and I think he may make a couple here. The Rams secondary is very good. They may be able to shut down DK Metcalf, and if they do, that would be a huge step to stopping the Seahawks offense. But I think the Rams offense is in store for a big game. Everyone has a big game against the Seahawks defense because they're bad, and I think Jared Goff might have a big game. Robert Woods, Cooper Kupp, both of them might have 100 yards receiving, and even the running game should help, and that should help the Rams offense be explosive. I think it might be high scoring, but maybe a slowdown towards the end of the game, and it might be a bit hard fought at the end with defenses showing up late. But I think the Seahawks with Wilson, Russell is not going to have another bad game. He'll have a decent game, and I think the Seahawks defense might actually have a better game after their thrashing last week. It might be a performance for the Seahawks defense to show up, maybe. And it's going to be hard fought. Seahawks Rams is always like that. And it should be, you know, a pretty good game. Seahawks Rams, another divisional rivalry, another divisional matchup key here. In the NFC West, Seahawks 32, Rams 30, a little high scoring game here. Looking for Russell Wilson to have a much better game after throwing two interceptions in the Rams. Facing a weak Seahawks defense, score 30, but it's not enough to beat Russell Wilson in this divisional match. Next game we have is on Monday Night Football, the Bears taking on the Vikings. Vikings should be able to win this game. Dalvin Cook has been amazing, over 200 yards last week. I think he might have 100 yards at least this week. The Bears defense is pretty stout. Kirk Cousins hasn't really had the best of games against the Bears. He may not have one, but they'll definitely rely on Dalvin Cook. Defensively, the Vikings are not that good. Allen Robinson might be in store for a big game for the Bears, but offensively, the Bears are just lethargic and boring, straight up. I don't think they'll be able to do that much. They may have a little bit of a better game, but honestly, they're not going to show up well. The Vikings should win this game. I think Kirk Cousins might have a couple of plays. Maybe it's a Justin Jefferson. And I think the Vikings will win this game, not easily, but by enough. NFC North rivalry here, Bears-Vikings on Monday Night Football. Vikings making a great comeback over the past few games with Dalvin Cook. And the Bears just looking uglier day by day. Bears 22. And the Vikings 26. Vikings are on a roll. My video and my predictions. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, go down, hit the like button, subscribe to my channel for weekly NFL power rankings and predictions. So it's pretty much just going to be the NFL from now on until probably the end of December, so the new year. So it's going to be pretty much NFL until then. So for an NFL fan, it's pretty much what you want all the time. So once again, hope you enjoy, and I hope to see you next time in my video. See you later.